I'm gonna show you the most popular way to hack a website where you can steal private information, hijack accounts, take over web pages and other illegal things to get you thrown in jail. Hold on, this isn't for legal activity, it's for educational purposes only. Notice the lights are on, I'm not wearing a hoodie, and I don't even have a Matrix themed terminal. So there's no crime going on here. You have to promise me you'll use this information for good and not evil. So when you're ready, this is the recipe for the basics of cross-site scripting. Hello world, I'm Jesse from Chef Secure. Cross-site scripting, or XSS, is a security vulnerability in web applications that allows evil hackers to inject their own code inside a web page. Yep, that's bad. With the power of scripting, cybercriminals can use your web applications to steal passwords, install malware, or worse. The ingredients for this recipe are HTML tags, JavaScript functions, JavaScript numbers, and JavaScript strings. The first step in cross-site scripting is to inject a script element into a web page. Now, web pages are built using HTML, which uses tags to create elements. Yep, there are a lot of them. Let's get started. Go to the script injection example for this recipe below, and pause the video when you need to so you can follow along and gain hands-on experience rather than just sitting there all awkwardly watching me do everything by myself. You can see that when you type something in and click the update button, it gets rendered on the page. So if you add more HTML, what do you think would happen? Open an HTML tag using less than and greater than characters surrounding an element name like P for paragraph. Then add some content and then add a closing tag after that, which is just the same as an opening tag, only there's a slash in front of the element name. Then click the update button. You see that instead of writing text, you actually change the HTML of the web page by adding a new paragraph element. While simple, this is very, very powerful because JavaScript controls the web page. And if you can inject a script element instead, you now control exactly what happens in the browser. And this is how XSS works. So go ahead and inject script tags this time. Start with your opening script tag, followed by your closing script tag. Now for the content that goes inside, this, my friends, is where we enter the f***ed up world of JavaScript. Wonderful world of JavaScript. JavaScript can be confusing at times, but what it does well, it does exceptionally well, like letting you hack websites. Or making them more interactive. Performing actions in JavaScript is like any other programming language where you just call functions. You can do this by typing the name followed by parentheses. And anything that goes inside the parentheses gets passed as data or arguments that the function can use. And like other programming languages, you can set values using an equal sign. Right now, try calling the alert function within your script tags. So type in alert followed by parentheses, then click the update button and watch your script execute. Because you see this alert pop up, it means your script was injected into the page successfully and ran due to an XSS vulnerability. While you're at it, get some practice with arguments as well. So type in the number 1 to the alert function, click the update button, and you'll see it alert 1. Or pass in text surrounded by either single or double quotes to make a string, and you can alert something you really love. I'm going to alert food. Because I love food. I'm always thinking about, wait a second, Chef Secure? Alerting is the most common function used by both cybercriminals and security researchers alike to find vulnerabilities in websites. Now keep in mind that the alert function is just a placeholder showing that a script can be injected. And once a vulnerability is found, an attacker can easily replace this with a malicious exploit that causes much more damage. Consider something simple. Instead of alerting in our example, let's just destroy the whole web page by removing all the HTML. In JavaScript, document.documentElement.innerHTML contains all the HTML of the web page. So just change it by setting it equal to an empty string. In our example, if we type that in, document.documentElement.innerHTML equals empty string, click the update button, and it's gone. I'm going to show you more about how cyber criminals can exploit websites in a later recipe, but if you're just testing for vulnerabilities, an alert is really all you need most of the time. So from here, what you really need is just to be creative and explore so you can find more vulnerabilities. Say you need to type in something in a website, such as a username or a status update. There's always a chance that it could contain an XSS vulnerability, so it's worth a shot. Of course, websites do have protections against XSS, some of them even built directly into the frameworks on which they're built. But despite this, and despite the frameworks being around for several years, the number of XSS vulnerabilities is still rising like crazy, and that's because writing secure, resilient code can be quite tricky at times. And even with automatic protection, you can still screw things up pretty badly. Trust me. I've done it more than once, and I'll do it again, I promise. But that's the point of having defense in depth, which I will teach you as we go along in this course. But mistakes happen, so let's look on the bright side. At least there are plenty of vulnerabilities to find and fix before cyber criminals can come and hack your application. Wait, that's not comforting at all. But that's all the time I have for now. Goodbye, friends.